Hey guys, so one of the pillars of the fire spinning community here in the United States is Coleman camp fuel, otherwise known as white gas. And it is so popular here that sometimes it's just considered to be the base fire spinning fuel. Over the past few weeks, a number of different retail outlets have been replacing their stocks of Coleman camp fuel with fuel that's made by another company called Krohn. And a lot of people have been flooding the online forums asking whether or not Krohn fuel is safe to spin with. So the good news is that this means that people are really concerned about safety, and more specifically, the safety of the fuels that they're using. The bad news is that this is one of those cases where a little bit of wrong information, or even a little bit of right information, gets interpreted wildly out of context. So I'm going to do my best here to try and sort through some of that. Now, for all intents and purposes, Krohn and Coleman fuel are virtually identical. The biggest difference is that Krohn has a chemical additive called toluene. Now, toluene is a hexane derivative that is frequently used as an octane booster. You can find it in most gasolines. And it's also this ingredient that most people are fixated on. Now, toluene has been getting so much attention because in large doses, it is toxic. Interestingly enough, a lot of people have been claiming that it's carcinogenic. The irony being that while most of the chemical compounds in our fuels are indeed carcinogenic, toluene is one of the few that aren't. In large doses, toluene can cause both respiratory as well as cognitive problems, everything from dizziness to nausea, sleepiness, and even death. But the question is there enough toluene in Krohn fuel to be a problem? According to the MSDS datasheet, toluene makes up 50 parts per million in every gallon of Krohn fuel, or roughly 170 milligrams. Cognitive problems start to set in once you get a dosage of more than 450 milligrams per kilogram per day in the average person. Now, I weigh 145 pounds, or about 66 kilograms. That means to start to see any of those cognitive problems emerge, I have to be exposed to about 30,000 milligrams, or just 30 grams of toluene per day. That means I'd have to be exposed to 175 gallons of Krohn fuel a day. I can't spin that much fire. By comparison, toluene makes up between 1 and 25% by volume of the gasoline that you buy at the pump each and every day. Now, if we assume the lower range of that at 1%, that still means that there's 37 grams of toluene in every gallon of gas that you pump. That's 217 times the amount of toluene that you're exposed to in a single gallon of Krohn fuel. Now, I'm one of the organizers at Flame Festival, and when this question came up for us, we actually went and consulted with a couple chemists. The answer that we got was that there aren't enough significant differences between Krohn and Coleman fuel to consider one to be more hazardous than the other. Now, I want to emphasize again, it is a good thing that people are concerned about the safety of the fuels that they're using for spinning fire. There's no two ways about it. We have a dangerous hobby, and the more educated we are about it, the better. If you're interested in learning more about fuel safety, or indeed safety in general, you should go check out the series of videos that have been produced by the Flow Arts Institute that I will link to in the annotations as well as the description of this video. It's really, really worth your time, and it clears up a few of these questions. Also, I'll include links to the sources of information that I used in compiling this video down in the description too. All that said, the hysteria is unwarranted. Krohn is just as safe as Coleman's. If you're familiar with white gas as a fuel, you can expect the same thing out of both manufacturers. Thanks for watching, and be safe out there. Peace. Hey guys, this video was made possible thanks to all of my awesome supporters over on Patreon. They have been supporting me in my goal of creating an online knowledge base for the Flow Arts, which includes things like the safety of new fuels. So if you are interested in supporting this project, please hop on over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and sign up to help me out. Thanks in advance.